Blogging is the most important art form of our generation. And as a Twitter verified blogger, I'm about to share with you my tried and tested formula so you too can become a millionaire through blogging. Now for starters, you're gonna want two folders, one piece of Bristol board, and a series of cardboard squares. Now for the gripes, you're gonna wanna make a list of isms, a list of phobias, anything a person could take issue with. For the target, these squares can be sports, activities, something you saw on Facebook or scrolled through on your phone. You're not gonna wanna limit yourself because this is your time for personal flair. You're gonna wanna draw a square on the poster board, the words has a second square followed by problem. And now we have our backdrop. Take your target cards, shake it up, pop it on the wall. Shake that up, pop her on the wall. And now that we've got our setup, it's time to start blogging. Now reach in here, just grab a random one. Science has a racism problem. And I do recommend trying out a few with each ism. You never want to get married to an article. Perhaps the Ottawa Valley has a racism problem. Financial services or the hairstyling industry. We're gonna reach into the bag here for another gripe. Sexism. Bernie Sanders has a sexism problem. But again, that could have been beer, economics, medicine, Wikipedia, the Apple credit card, or the television show Curb Your Enthusiasm. Now, it's easy to get caught up wondering where this article would live, but it's important to remember that these places will publish anything. Now, we're gonna reach into the bag, grab another gripe. Islamophobia, always a fun one, and we match that up with Europe. Now, places are always fun, and as you know, we have an endless supply. That could have been Pakistan, that could have been the French. Grab yet another gripe, and what we've come up with is design has an ageism problem. Here's a fun one. The PR industry has an ageism problem. The outdoor industry has an ageism problem. Back to gripes here, we're gonna go with anti-Semitism. Back to the targets, the NBA has an anti-Semitism problem. Gay rights has an anti-Semitism problem, so you can mix and match different groups here. And lastly, we'll go with the Women's March has an anti-Semitism problem. Switching it up, ableism. That is a new one, but very popular, very profitable. Halloween has an ableism problem. Publishing has an ableism problem. Grab another gripe, that phobia. We're gonna match that up with a target, the left. Grab another gripe, homophobia. You know, lots of different publications for this article to land. Grab a couple targets, Israel. You know, law of large numbers, sort of a reverse of an article we saw earlier. Football has a homophobia problem. It's a favorite topic of mine, so I am gonna grab one more, and we land with Italy. You know, we've talked about places before. It's a target that continues to deliver. You know, and now that you've mastered two-tier blogging, you might have noticed that some articles appear to have a higher command of the English language. And although you're probably thinking, but I'm not a Harvard Lit graduate, the secret ingredient actually comes from a third folder titled SNAZ. And the SNAZ category is just some fun prefixes that can raise the tier of your article. And now we have our secret ingredient, the prefix. We need to talk about the transphobia problem in horror films. We need to talk about the sexism problem in science. And you can remember that's a throwback from earlier on in the tutorial. And again, that could have been it's time to address the sexism problem in science, as well as yes, we still have a sexism problem in science. It's also important to note that 98% of readers don't get past the headline before sharing, so you don't want to waste too much energy on the body of the article. In the past, I've even substituted article body text with lorem ipsum without anyone noticing, including my editor. In some cases, the article body is even locked behind a paywall that zero people subscribe to. Now, I want to thank everyone for watching the tutorial. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and make sure you tune in next week. I'm going to teach you a technique called double Dutch and how to write an article title so confusing that it makes it almost impossible to refute. Happy blogging.
Even doctors don't want to say fat. They'd be like, listen, if you could be 30% less brave, that'd be great.